It's unbelievable. Just watch this play.
Hello, everyone. I'm John Davidson. Welcome to NHL Ice Hot, the best of the 1995-96 season from the coolest game on earth. I've been around hockey for, well, let's just say my entire life. First as a player, and now as a television analyst. And I can honestly say that the 1995-96 season had it all. I'm talking about great saves, bone-jarring hits, unbelievable goals, and dramatic comebacks. So if you're a hockey fan, sit down, buckle up, and get ready. Because for the next hour, you're going to see the absolute best NHL action from last season. And we're going to start with the goal scorers. You know, when you break it all down, hockey is really a simple game. Put the puck in the net. Well, it sounds simple enough anyway. But when you put a great goalie in the net and a couple of dedicated defensemen in the way, it becomes more difficult. What we did was pick the top 20 goals scored last season, and we begin with numbers 20 through 11. You'll have to wait for the top 10 until later in the show. So from the home office in Tappan, New York, here now are 10 of the best goals scored in the NHL last season.
Starting it off at number 20, Tampa Bay's John Cullen bolts past the Canadiens' defense.
Look at this! What a move! Cullen right up there with a score!
Cullen just dipsy-doodled his way in around, got in a perfect position, and put that puck right upstairs on Jablonski. Cullen's prettiest of the year.
At 19, Colorado's Joe Sakic one-times the Avalanche into the finals.
Sakic shot. No. Yes, he scores! Joe Sakic!
How about that shot by Joe Sakic? What a laser. An absolute laser.
At 18, teammate Peter Forsberg plays the carom to complete a finals hat trick.
Sakic the shot. Deflected wide by Forsberg. He scores!
At number 17, Jeff Courtnell has the Avalanche singing the blues.
The defense, he's in alone. Katie shoots, he scores!
Well, he puts a tremendous move on Sandis Ozilinch. He puts the puck way out to the right, then slips it through him. Ozilinch was going the other way. Now he just gets a piece of this puck, and it goes through the legs of Patrick Watt.
Montreal's Saku Koivu turns Sergei Zubov inside out at number 16.
Koivu walking to the net, in on goal, a shot, he scores! What a play by Koivu!
He sees the ice well, he looks for his holes, and he's got some great talent.
Florida's Martin Straka and Bill Lindsay work the give-and-go to upset the Pens in the playoffs.
Bill Lindsay to Straka, scores! Move by Straka, and then the give-and-go. Bill Lindsay puts it right back on the tape. And Straka makes no mistake.
At number 14, the Canucks' Alexander Mogilny burns the Habs.
Mogilny, one on two, makes a great move, and on goal, scores! Now there's a goal scorer, Alex Mogilny.
Keith Tkachuk dives into our countdown at number 13.
Here's another chance. Tkachuk ball, Solani scores!
This good play by Tkachuk, diving, getting the puck to Solani. Solani makes no mistake on that one.
At 12, Jaromir Jagr proves you don't need to be on your skates to score.
Jagr backhand shot, save, Albright. He got score! And it was tapped in on his knees.
Well, the fans are dancing exactly the way Jagr just danced. And I'll tell you what, this baby's going to make a highlight reel.
And at number 11, Clayton Beddoes makes his first NHL goal a memorable one.
Nice job by Beddoes to keep it in. Beddoes from the ice, score!
But not all NHL plays work out as planned. Take this rush by Claude Lemieux, for example. Hockey is a finely choreographed sport. Well, most of the time.
Watch out for that stick!
No wonder they call it a heads-up game. Unlike other athletes, hockey players use sticks. And the great ones use theirs like magic wands.
He gets his stick caught in the boards.
Boy, they don't make sticks the way they used to.
That's unbelievable. Let's just watch it.
Yeah. Watch out for that stick.
I tell you, even when the Penguins' Mario Lemieux is down, he's not out. Not many guys can make this pass while on the seat of their pants. Here's the final word on hockey sticks. If you want them to take care of you, you've got to take care of them. Although, this is a bit extreme. Everyone knows goaltenders are different. That's why they make great highlights.
Oh, sorry, pal.
Go long. I'll give it to you.
How about that? That's all-time hockey right there. That's what they used to play without a goaltender's mask.
In Hollywood, there's a lot more to playing goal than just stopping pucks.
It's a weird night. It's not Halloween tonight, but it sure seems like it.
Looks like he thinks he has it in his glove. Whoops.
My goodness.
My advice to young goalies is stay in the crease. You can't make a save while you're wandering.
An empty net, they won't come, as you said, Paul, any easier than that.
This is a weird one. The shot misses the net wide, but look how it bounces up.
But then again, staying close to home doesn't guarantee that you'll make the save either.
And comes directly back, hits Rhodes on the foot.
You want to talk about a team getting a bad break.
Well, that's a way to get your first NHL goal.
Remember, guys, try and be useful because you can all be replaced.
Now, just so that I don't get any mail from goaltenders around the league, I want to say that the producers forced me to say that last line. Being a former goalie myself, I would never compare you guys to a dog. It's too insulting. To you, of course. Insulting to you, not the dog. I've also heard all the comments about goalies being a little off the wall or walking to a different beat, whatever. But you have to respect and admire the talent and determination of NHL goalies. To do what they do, night in and night out, with all that equipment on, and never get themselves a break. Remember, they don't have line changes. I can tell you from experience, it's exhausting both physically and emotionally. How about that? Still got it a little bit anyway. With that said, let's take a look back at the best saves of the year from the coolest goaltenders on earth.
Control fires across, saved by Richter!
Wow.
Unbelievable save!
And now for some playoff heroics.
For a try, a save by Richter. He robbed Brian Savage with a brilliant save. Open net. The Fusi front save. Another save. Richter is unbelievable. Another save of the Fusi.
He's a magician out there.
Oh, it's the best he's been since 94 in the Stanley Cup Finals. It is showtime, baby.
Makes a move. Stop by Coleman. Oh, what a save by Regan.
Oh, baby, what a play. Oh, baby, what a save.
And he wraps up. Save, John Casey. Save today for Shane Bourne.
Delios. How about that glove save?
And now for the best of the best. This wouldn't be complete without the Hasek block.
The best save. Hasek got the right hand down and made an outstanding save. A standing ovation for Hasek.
And finally, the save of the season provided by Detroit's Chris Osgood.
Oh, is that the catch of the year?
He may have once been able to hide, but not anymore. Devils goaltender Martin Brodeur was named Rookie of the Year in 1994, led the Devils to the Stanley Cup in 1995, and was voted to his first All-Star game this past season. Right now we've got a special treat. We're going to take you inside the 1996 NHL All-Star Weekend from the perspective of Martin Brodeur.
Can you hear me?
All right.
The way they do it, it's a little scary, eh? The breakaways. All six guys going to look at us and just, okay. It's my turn to go.
Here's Owen Nolan from San Jose. Over the door, stacking him that time.
Peter Forsberg, and he scores.
Joe Sakic out of Colorado will be the next shooter. Brodeur in for the Devils. Beat him on the glove side.
He's not bad breakaway so either. Sakic. He roofed it on me.
Boy, the goaltender does have to move. You got to go back and forth just like this. On him on the whistle. Brodeur had gone 6 out of 10.
Yeah, you know what? We were losing. We're losing by 2.
And Roman Hamerlin beats him with a nice move.
Matthew Schneider from the Islanders. They've tied.
Mario, you better score. You better score. Come on, Dominic.
They're still tied, and a go-ahead goal.
I would have a glove on that. You gotta pick me.
Mark's got the score to keep him alive. Eddie Belfour makes the save of the West. That's one. What a great finish to the skills competition, with the West winning it overall 13-12.
With the Super Skills event completed, it was time for the main event. The 46th Annual All-Star Classic.
From the Stanley Cup champion New Jersey Devils, number 30, Martin Brodeur.
You guys, don't look at me like that when I'm talking, okay? I don't like it.
Salami, back to Gretzky, backhander save, rebound, oh, knocked down in front. Got a shot away, but it is held by Brodeur. Sandin's in, Sandin with a backhander, but it is brought back.
Too many men on the ice for the Western side.
Not too many men. Wow. Wow. All those All-Stars? Can't happen.
Brett Hall's shot denied by Brodeur.
Brodeur's playing time was over, but alongside Panther goaltender John Van Beesbrouck, he managed to even enjoy his first All-Star game from the bench.
What's going on with the Panthers right now? They're doing so well. You're the key, man, that's why, eh?
Yeah, I'm the key. You know what? I was looking at Dominic before. He kind of looks like olive oil from Popeye.
Sacking ahead, Sundin is in. Sundin, save!
It's the Dominator.
Dominator.
The Dominator is on our side. Let's get a big goal. Maybe that's going to be a car for someone.
A shot went off the lane. Rebound. Score! Raymond Moore
guy so devoted to Boston. Here's some of the devotion sent right back to him.
So it was the first one. That was great. Something special. I'll remember all the time. We won too, so that's even great.
What a fitting end to a great All-Star game, with hometown hero Ray Bourque winning the Bud Ice Most Valuable Player Award. For Ray, it was his 14th All-Star game. Only three people have played more. Meanwhile, Brodeur delivered 20 minutes of shutout hockey in his All-Star debut. The 95-96 season saw more than just a few milestones accomplished. More fans attended NHL games than any other year in history. Television ratings were at an all-time high as well. But whether you went to the arena or watched on television, you were treated to some memorable moments. Here's a few.
Bobby crisscrossing with Fedorov, though. Second late man coming, Larry Arbo, shot!
For his 300th NHL victory.
Out to the right point, Quinn, a shot, deflects to Salani. Oh, baby, what a save by Fuhr. And time runs out, and the Blues win it. The Blues will congratulate Grant Fuhr, his 300th career victory.
Patrick Roy's had a couple of cracks at 300. We'll see if he gets it tonight.
But they're the kind of numbers that separate you and put you in a class all by yourself. And that's the class of Patrick Roy joined tonight.
Back to Beckerberg. Here's Stevens with a drive. Deflected, score! And good jump. Career point number 1,000 for Dave Averjohn in his 998th game.
Pulled up on Brett Hennigan. It's centered out in front. Murphy to the backhand. He scores! Point number 1,000. A goal for Larry Murphy, and the Leaf bench is empty.
Line to Pearson. Not a Howard Chuck shooting. He scores! Howard Chuck number 500. Oh, baby, a huge one for Dale Howard Chuck. He will get a big ovation from the appreciative fans here in Toronto.
So now Mario Lemieux is out to make a little bit of history. We may be in for some of it tonight. His next goal will be his 500th. Here's Sandstrom, number 17. Now Lemieux, and there's number 500. Mario Lemieux has become the second fastest 500 goal scorer in National Hockey League history.
Great shot in the corner. Ever in the city of Detroit, and congratulations to Steve Yzerman, goal number 500. Now every time Mark Messier steps out on the ice could be an historic moment. Much pass brains to Messier. He shoots, he scores! Mark Messier, number 500, and it's a hat trick! What a night for Mark Messier!
Oh, do they love their captain, and he's leading tonight. 500.
Those moments were very special. It always is in sports when records are set and milestones achieved. But no records are kept at all for perhaps the most exciting aspect of hockey, the physical side. A great check can intimidate an opponent and change the momentum of a game. It also appeals to our aggressive nature as fans. It pumps up the crowd and can be as exciting as a great goal or save. So buckle up your seatbelts, because here are some of the greatest checks from the toughest guys on earth.
Let's do it! Let's get it on! Let's get ready to rumble!
A patented hit by Jovo Cop. Look out!
Hit. See why it takes courage to play this game of hockey. Contact blocked with no out of bounds. Here's the freight train, number 88, Eric Lindros.
Heavy metal is in the National Hockey League.
But dang, that's a major league body check and a good clean one.
Get ready for incoming missiles.
JR is definitely back.
Jarring hit, you better make sure you don't have any screws loose. At the rink, you expect the coach to get on your case. But your wife? All right, dear, all right. If you insist, we'll put fish on the menu.
Holy mackerel!
Seafood? Not for these whalers. Here's Sergei doing his dolphin stuck in the net routine. Hey, Detroit fans, could you find a mascot that stinks a little less?
It smells awful.
That's cold. Here's Boston's anthem singer Rene Rancor being forced to fish for a new microphone. Talk about thinking on your feet. Some of our officiating friends could use some help staying on their feet.
Colorado, this is called sumo wrestling, but to me, it's the aggressiveness in front of the net. That's exactly what Mark Crawford's looking for. That, folks, is aggressive hockey. Oh, big hit. My, oh, my.
You better be alert playing in the NHL. Otherwise, you can get a real headache out there.
Oh, look at this.
Hasek is out.
Oh, my.
Ouch.
Watch the helmet.
You can lose your head if you're not careful, which might not be a bad idea for some of us.
I think we've taken too many high sticks, Sam.
Uh-oh. A guy can lose face in a rink, especially when he loses a puck in his own net.
Oh, he scores! Coffee knocking in his own net!
I guess a goalie can't trust anyone these days.
I think Jeff Brown shot it in his own net. He did!
Fans love hockey for its high-speed collisions, no matter who gets hit.
Just make a change. Get over.
It always amazes me that teams who have battled through seven physical games immediately become best friends once their series ends.
Hey, great series, man. You were outstanding. You played great.
No. You were great. Oh,
thank you.
Hey, you guys playing any golf?
I guess we are.
Yeah, now we are. Thanks to you guys. Thanks for nothing.
Hey, how's the family?
Oh, those kids are growing like weeds.
Let's get together real soon.
Well, that's not really what's said during post-game handshakes. But it is a ritual that is unique to this game, and I, for one, think it speaks volumes as to the class and sportsmanship of NHL players. Of course, it doesn't happen after each game, just during the NHL playoffs, which are unique themselves because of one extraordinary aspect, sudden death overtime. One shot, one goal. One team goes home for the summer, the other advances towards Lord Stanley's Cup. This past spring, there were 19 overtime encounters. Let's take a look and listen at the intensity and emotion of sudden death overtime in the NHL playoffs.
Ahead, Pratt, off his stick. Played ahead, blocked by Pratt. Cuts it into the Flyer zone, drops in the slot. Bellows, a shot, yes!
It's on! Yes, sir! Yes, sir!
Coaching staff, they go home with a 3-2 lead.
Oselic drops it back, batting, and they score! Joey Sakic's done it again! Johnny, the safe NHL season, gave it up, found it up, scores! Joe Murphy! The Hawks complete the sweep.
Two games apiece.
It's over! Finally! Overtime heaven is a series winner!
Now the top 10 goals of the year, starting with Kelly Miller's sweet setup of Steve Konowalczyk.
Kelly Miller, spin around.
At 9, Darren Turcotte turns on the Jets in Detroit.
Ooh, nice play. Turcotte, he's in for the backhand, scores! Darren Turcotte, he looked like a goal scorer there. What a move he made.
In Buffalo, Brad May sets up Pat LaFontaine single-handedly.
May hustling in there with that pass.
The Canadiens' Benoit Brunet leaves the Kings in the dust at number 7.
This is Brunet coming back the other way. Poivu up to join him. Look at Brunet. Look at that. I don't believe it. What a move. Benoit Brunet making like Wayne Gretzky on that play.
At number 6, Tony Amonte dazzles Detroit with this burst of speed.
He moves up the left side, speeds in on Bergevin, cuts him out.
By Tony. He knew he had the angle and he went for it.
Jaromir Jagr starts off our final 5 with a spectacular move against Boston.
I mean, is this kid good or what?
The 100th point of the season for Jaromir Jagr.
At number 4, Bill Lindsay's solo effort helped Florida upend the Bruins in the playoffs.
Lindsay working on goal. And from Lindsay scores!
Here, the biggest goal in franchise history so far. Bill Lindsay just slides the puck in under Bill Ranford.
Former Penguin Marcus Naslund dives into our countdown at number 3.
Marcus Naslund goes through 2 men, now third. Backhander score!
What a play by Marcus Naslund. He went through 3 men and scores on a backhander on his stomach. Get in the fast lane, Grandma. The bingo game is ready to roll. What a goal by Marcus Naslund.
At number 2, Red Wings goalie Chris Osgood shows us his offensive skills.
Wesley out to center, dumps it in. Osgood handles, looks to clear it himself. He does. Going for the empty goal. It's Chris Osgood scores! Chris Osgood does the unthinkable. You don't see that too often. To say the least, this is a goaltender's dream.
And at number 1, hey, they don't call him Super Mario for nothing.
Lemieux, Berkey back into the Canucks and trying to tee it up. Puck goes in, the Penguins have scored. Somehow Lemieux put that puck in.
Let's see what he does here. Oh, my goodness. Well, there's not another guy on earth that can do that. So.
Yeah, I didn't even realize he had done it.
Well,
I had no idea. Watch this play by Lemieux.
That's one for the highlight reel of all time.
Wow, what a goal by the great Mario Lemieux. Why don't we for a second just get into the head of the goaltender. You become the goaltender. Just think about Mario moving down on a breakaway. Now, the idea is to anticipate, to cheat a little bit, as we say. What is he going to do? Well, he can beat you with speed. He can beat you with a great shot. He's very accurate with it. And that long reach with that graceful stride, he can go around you at any time. It's kind of nice to be retired and just watch Mario these days. And, of course, with Chris Osgood scoring the goal, you get this feeling. If his coach, Scotty Bowman, allows him, he may get a couple more next year. We've kept our promise we made at the top of the show. We've shown the great goals, unbelievable saves, tremendous checks, and the great playoff finishes. So it's appropriate we end the show with the one topic we haven't covered, the 1996 Stanley Cup Finals between the powerhouse Colorado Avalanche and the Cinderella Florida Panthers. I'm John Davidson. We hope you enjoyed our look back, and we'll see you next year with another edition of NHL Ice Hot, the best of the NHL. The Sun Belt embraced the Stanley Cup in 96, and although the teams were new to the finals, both Florida and Colorado had veteran stars in goal. John Van Beesbrouck and Patrick Waugh put on a tremendous show. As advertised, Waugh shined throughout the playoffs.
Oh, what a save there!
Offensively, Joe Sakic emerged as the hero for the Avalanche.
Now Ozilek with it. Sakic!
But Waugh's feud with Chicago's Jeremy Roenick triggered the best shot of the postseason.
I can't really hear what Jeremy says because
I got my two Stanley Cup rings plug in my ear.
In the finals, Wah would face the giant killers of the 96 playoffs, the red-hot Florida Panthers.
From Lindsay scores! Bill Lindsay puts the Panthers back in front!
A classic Stanley Cup matchup, Van Beesbrouck versus Wah, Colorado versus Florida, with both clubs trying to win the game within the game.
That's what we want. We want aggression. Aggression in that circle, boys. We go after them.
Back down comes Forsberg. Oh, and a hit by Fitzgerald on Forsberg. Fitzgerald turning, looking for help, and the pass is controlled by Lindsay to Fitzgerald. He scores!
And these Florida Panthers have struck again.
Way to go, Fitz. Big goal. Out of the skate, Billy.
Out of Forsberg. Finesse by Tom, and he broke rebound.
Come on, man. Let's go. All we need is one to get it going here, eh? Set it up!
Hooked off and up by Barnes, then he slowed it down, but now it's got Young with a shot. Young, and it's high!
These are the shifts that are real important right after.
Ozilek's bend to Keane, and the shot floated by. Reaching!
Back-to-back goals in less than 2 minutes had Florida reeling.
What are we about, guys? What are we about? We're about work!
But the blue-collar Panthers simply couldn't contain the talents of Colorado.
Again in front. Group.
Score! Group. Oh, what a pass from Valeri Kamensky! And what a finish!
Deflated by the Game 1 loss, breathing had become a chore for the Panthers.
Lungs open up a little bit.
We are. We just can't breathe. Can you breathe? Holy cow.
Peter Forsberg didn't mind being a mile high for game two.
Near side, Forsberg shot, score! Oh, it's hit red hot! Deflected wide by Forsberg, he scores! A pure hat trick for Peter Forsberg!
The news for Florida only got worse in game three. Claude Lemieux was back for Colorado.
Now, Peter, come up together. We're gonna burn him.
Those Lynch connects with Lemieux and back onto Forsberg.
Their fans did not let Wah dodge their patented rat attack.
He scores!
The speed has picked up for the rat trap.
Florida had the lead, but Colorado had the answer.
Focus on your next shift. Use our brain. You cannot skate with us.
Nearly 3 minutes played in the second period. Colorado has started to take over and moving it in second.
Sakic's 18th was all Wah needed. Both goaltenders dominated game four.
McCord Murphy, forehand wrister, saved by Wah. Rebound, side of the net, the more jamming. Patrick Wah's got it.
Here we go, Red. Come on, boys. Third one.
Sakic coming, 2-on-2. Sakic, Reichel cutting ahead of him. Sakic, save, Reichel into the net, but the puck didn't go with him.
Big stop.
And we are going to overtime in game four.
Great ones thrive under stress. John Van Beesbrouck's game reached new heights as Florida faced elimination.
Centered again. In foot. Dropped it. Shot. Deflected off the crossbar. Young shot. How did that not go in the net? Forsberg moving it in. Forsberg comes from the middle. Forsberg sending off the left. Oh, what a save! John Van Beesbrouck!
Could Colorado's amazing offensive talent be shut down for six straight periods?
All right. Just press them here, boys.
Trying to clear, didn't get it out. Sakic held it in. Still held in. Uwe Krupp shot. Score! The Colorado Avalanche took over the Stanley Cup!
What unforgettable goaltending.
Congratulations.
Joe Sakic became the playoff MVP and along with his teammates cherished their moment in the sun. Whoa. Got it. Well, let's take a look back at some of the best saves of the year from the coolest goaltenders on earth, and that was absolutely awful. Let's say...
It's 2-on-1. Nedved in front. Score!
This team cannot buy a break.
Better off. Oh,
my. Look at this.
It's in the net.
Oh, my goodness.
stick. Watch the blade fly up high as a boomerang.
Hello, Chief. This is 86.
Here's Dvorak. Getting one in wide of Osgood. Scores!
How about that?
A great check can intimidate an opponent. Well, that's what... Yeah.